When your AC stops working, just call the experts at KS Services Heating and Air. They're fast and affordable. Right now, purchase any Bryant Energy Efficient System and save with 0% interest for 60 months with approved credit. It comes included with a 5-year labor warranty. And our fair price guarantee means that we will always give you 3 quotes for every situation. A good, better, and best. Call KS Services Heating and Air today. We roll on, whatever it takes.
This is your Weather Xtreme video for Saturday, August the 19th. I'm meteorologist Brian Peters. Thanks so much for tuning in. Satellite image this morning shows that we do have a few streaks of cirrus clouds across the Alabama sky, and there may be a few places with some lower stratus clouds, but they're hard to see on the infrared picture. We do have what is sometimes referred to as a backdoor cold front, since it's kind of settling into the area more from the northeast than from the north or northwest. As a result, we've seen some drier air filter into the area. The upper atmosphere features this trough over the eastern part of the country that has been a sort of a semi-permanent feature this summer. And that's been good because that's kept the excessive heat away from our area and across the eastern part of the country. Temperatures this morning are in pretty good contrast. 61 there at Fort Payne, and our sky watcher at Black Creek reported 61 as well, but 73 down at Tuscaloosa. So a 12-degree range between west central and northeast Alabama. Those are pretty substantial ranges for the summertime. Our watch warning map features a lot of the orange areas over parts of Arkansas, Louisiana, Mississippi, and Oklahoma, and a little bit of eastern Texas. That's all the heat advisories. We have flash flood watches over southern New Mexico, and we have high fire danger over parts of Montana and Idaho. The QPF over the next 5 days is pretty slim for much of Alabama, and the reason for that is that probably not going to see much in the way of showers over the weekend and maybe even into Monday, but then shower chances come up a little bit on Tuesday and Wednesday and Thursday. This only goes through Thursday morning, so not a great deal of rain forecast. Storm Prediction Center has a small, slight risk over parts of south-central Nebraska, with marginal risks surrounding that and a marginal risk area over parts of Ohio, West Virginia, and Pennsylvania for day two. And for day three, there is a marginal risk in the north-central part of the United States from Nebraska over towards Lake Michigan. All right, the tropics are pretty busy. We have 3 areas in the Atlantic that we're being watched. We'll take these one at a time. There's a little bit closer look at Tropical Storm Harvey. Harvey is not expected to gain much strength as it moves away from the Leeward Islands across the east central part of the Caribbean and continues on a west to northwest track. Right now, the track continues to kind of evolve a little further to the north, as it looks like yesterday it was expected to come across the Honduran coast, but it looks like now like it'll skirt just to the north. We're going to have to watch this when it gets over into the southwest Gulf, although at the moment there's no immediate threat to anybody over this way. The second area, a little bit of a close-up there, is a forecast to move into the area just to the north of Puerto Rico. And as you can see from this track, it's going to, in about 3 to 4 days, could be threatening the Bahamas. And then the final area, the one most furthest east, is likely to recurve, as you see here, and stay well out in the Atlantic. All right, the 06E GFS model run. And there's a look at our chances for rain today, and you can see that they're pretty low. And the reason for that is we have much lower humidity. If anybody gets any showers, it will be down across west central Alabama and down along the Mississippi line down to Mobile. That would be the only place I think showers would develop today. The ridge noses in from Bermuda on Sunday, and once again, though, that keeps us in relatively dry air, so I think Sunday we stay dry as well. The upper ridge noses in all the way across from the Bermuda High all the way across to Texas on Monday, and precipitable water values are beginning to come up. I think the better chance for showers would be across the southern part of the state, but this may be a situation where we'll need to introduce a 10 or 20% chance of showers. On Tuesday, the very strong trough moving across southern Canada and south central Canada there is beginning to have its impact as it begins to dampen the ridge a little bit. But at the surface, moisture begins to surge back to the north. So I think Tuesday, shower chances come back up into the 30, 40, maybe 50% range or so. And the GFS certainly suggesting that with the surface pattern. We can also note there that the front coming through Michigan and down into Missouri, and that will be advancing southeastward. That strong trough moves across southern Canada, and again, it's helping to dampen the ridge over the southeastern U.S. So once again, by Wednesday, we're back out of any kind of real warmth at all. And we can see the GFS is suggesting the front will make it down into the Carolinas and across Tennessee. It's going to be a question of exactly how far south it's going to come, because it's not going to have much of a push. As you can see, we still have troughiness over the eastern part of the country on Thursday. And the front, according to the GFS, will make it down into the area. If you look at a little closer at precipitable water values, it looks like definitely the Tennessee Valley would probably be out of showers on Thursday. And central Alabama, probably 30-40% chance of showers for that day. The troughiness stays with us as it advances over to the east coast on Friday. And as you can see from the precipitable water values, we still have showers over the south part of the state for sure, and probably mostly dry over the Tennessee River Valley. And us kind of between the two, probably some low chances for showers. The pattern does not change much in the upper atmosphere on Saturday. And as you can see, the moisture surges back to our area. So once again, it looks like showers would return for next Saturday. Looking out into Voodoo Country, the GFS remains pretty bullish on the idea of keeping this troughiness over the eastern part of the country. As you can see, the one strong closed low moving out from New England, while another closed low is coming in from south central Canada on the 28th of August. By the 31st, last day of August, we see that the troughiness is still there with a couple of little wiggles moving through the flow as another system is coming into the western part of Canada up there. But the GFS suggests that we may see some ridging by the 3rd of September, but that's a pretty strong closed low right behind that ridge. So it looks like that ridge would be sort of short-lived and may give us some warm weather over the Labor Day weekend. I'm meteorologist Brian Peters. Thanks for tuning in. I'll have the next one posted first thing on Monday morning. Have a great day and Godspeed. Sunday morning.
AC broken? Just call KS Services Heating and Air. All Bryant Energy Efficient systems come with a 5-year labor warranty. And our fair price guarantee means that we'll always give you 3 quotes for every situation. Just call KS Services Heating and Air today.